Welcome back to my channel. In this session I repaired this chigo air conditioner remote. It was not working, it was totally dead. There was no display on the LCD and there was no IR out. How I fixed it, let's see it. Friends, I have this remote. It is not powering on. It is for chigo air conditioner. If I press the button, there is no light from this LED. If we check the voltage here, so it is 3.1 volts. That means the batteries are good. It have no display. It don't have any LED light when I press button. So it is not responding. Let's open it. Sometimes it have one screw and some locks, push fitted locks. Remove these screws. Now open it. First of all, connect battery here in this condition and check voltage at this capacitor. DC voltage, it is 3.1 volt. That means the battery is making connection with the board. Remove the battery. Open these both screws. Using some alcohol, first of all clean it. If we see, this eyelet is damaged. Now we can see this eyelet is damaged. It has visible damage. Check continuity between these two points. It is not giving continuity. If we check between this, it is giving continuity. So it is not completing the circuit here. Let's make jumper. To make jumper, I will use this thin wire. Let's check it. Now I will install batteries and we will check the function. Is this connection is working or no? Yes, the processor started working. It is now working, but it don't have any display. Let's check why there is no display. If you see here, this track, this print is now damaged. And here we have one track, two, three, four. These four tracks have disconnection and the last one. So we need to make jumpers between these connections so that it will make connection with this connection pad. Use empty sheet and very carefully remove the coating here. Now I will use a very fine tip for the soldering iron. Now I will replace the tip of the soldering iron because it is chisel tip. I need needle tip. to work on this these tiny tracks. So it is now good. Now I will use a very thin wire, that is in this wire one conductor. I will use one conductor here. First of all, clean it. Now I am using the soldering paste. Now I am using liquid solder here. Instead of using solder wire. Now we need to tin it properly. And don't apply too much heat. Now remove the excessive amount of this flux paste. Now we want to make jumper from this point. Here. I made jumpers between these pins. Now let's connect it. Then we will check the result. Connect the battery. Yes, it is responding. And if we see the display, it is now displaying temperature. That's nice. Yes, it is now decreasing the temperature, changing the modes. That's nice. Let's pack it up. Yes, now it is good. Let's install these two screws. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.